Well, this tournament may only have been a week long, not even that, but in that very short time, it has been a real melting pot of footballing cultures from right around the world, unique to the continents represented by each of the teams taking part. There have been so many memorable displays of terrific sportsmanship, of fellowship, friendship, camaraderie, and the coronation to follow after this final will be its last memorable act. Unmistakably, this is the Camp Nou, staging a game in the way only the Camp Nou can. You've seen a lot of this type of tournament. What are you thinking about it?
Yeah, these games, Peter, are a real learning curve because you're coming up against teams and individual opponents that are unlikely to stick to what you really like them to do. That plays on your concentration and your ability to improvise against what you're facing whilst playing your part in your own team's tactics. So it really is time to switch on here.
Just who will seize their moment?
As with a lot of finals, caution plays a big part in the opening stages, but an early goal can blow all that away, so I hope that we can create an attacking contest here, which obviously we want for this showpiece.
To thread it through. This is quite a run, and he's not done yet. Plays it back. And he heaves it forward. Forward it goes. Goes for goal! That could turn out to be a big, big goal! Was there ever any doubt?
Well, he always had the measure of the keeper there. Such confidence and composure.
Big occasion, big goal, crucial lead.
Well, Peter, the emphasis should now switch to winning it rather than even thinking about losing it.
Borini. What's Borini? Borini decides to put... Big chance! It's bounced out! You can get that clear. Wrestled off the ball. Has a hit! He scored! And they're at it again in double quick time. His position was perfect. The invitation was there for him, and his response absolutely critical.
That's just a great finish, but it's down to very clever movement. You can see this has been obviously worked on the training ground. He knew exactly where he wanted the ball, and it all came good.
His second of the game, and an eye now for a hat-trick. Sunderland
have a couple of goals without reply. It's 2-0.
Well, it's been an absolutely fabulous spell for them, and they're starting to look unstoppable. There could be more on the way.
And that'll go straight through to the keeper.
Barini.
Looks to clip it forward. And helps available out wide.
That's a goal kick.
Just to point out, Peter, that the fullbacks are quite high.
And what are they trying to achieve?
Well, it's obviously a move to push the opposition wide men back and give them more to...
Going for goal!
A collective sigh of relief from the defence.
That's what all good teams do these days. Pressing from the front is highly effective.
That's not the ball he wanted.
Just brushed off the ball there. Trippier drives it forward.
A real chance to break. Brings it forward. Hoists it forward.
Trippier
tries to switch the play.
Played into space out wide.
Averted for now. Gets it back.
Is that a foul? Yes, the referee's given it. Over to the left.
Defence has got rid of that. And the counter is on.
He gets past his man.
Well read, he sorted that out.
And it's played forward.
Hoists it forward.
Boca Juniors
kick the ball, but can't do anything meaningful with it. Well played, he saw that coming.
Lovely bit of skill.
Oh, that's a fine challenge. And he's there to hoof it away.
Barini is onto it and can take it up. Borini. A really good feat. Trippier. Whistle's gone, and we've reached the halfway point of the final. That time in the final, Jim, how do you read it?
Sunderland have the lead, and obviously it's going to be the happiest rescue in the half-time, but it'll be interesting to see what they do second half. I really think that they should push on and do more of what we saw as we approached half-time.
Sunderland sitting pretty here at half-time, 2-0 up. Whistle goes, we're off and running. It's all a little short of forward momentum, lacking thrust. Come back to the keeper. Gets into a dangerous position. Calabi looking to hit the front line. Oh, well intercepted, really alert to the danger. Defenders on the back foot. Real chance! And more. And surely that settles it. And that is about as cool as they come. He picked his spot expertly.
Well, I think two keepers would have had a hard time keeping that one out, never mind one. There was real venom in the strike and clear composure from the placement.
He's made it three, quite a day at the office for him.
This is one of the best performances I've seen in a while. He's practically taken on this team single-handedly, and they don't know how to stop him.
Three without reply. This is becoming a stroll. Can't get the better of his opposite number. He spotted the run and played him through. He's left his man.
Oh, super tackle. They were outnumbered and under the cosh. That had to be spot on, and it was.
He's picked him out. What a ball. It's one! Perfect placement, the one place the keeper couldn't reach.
Now that's what I call finishing, right in the corner. He knew instinctively who was where and didn't need to waste any time weighing things up. That's a cracking goal.
Boca Juniors give themselves a fighting chance, back in with a shout. Tries to get it forward quickly. For a moment you thought that was going somewhere, but they'll have to go again. Juniors keeping their men at arm's length here.
Yeah, I just think it's a conservative move to deny runners the opportunity of going beyond that rear guard.
Calabria drives it forward. He's got options out wide.
Quality goal, lovely first touch, sumptuous second. Some activity down on the touchline. It seems there's going to be a change. So now the difference is three. Plays it out to the flank. The less said about that pass, the better. Boca Juniors making another change here. Up towards the front line. Forward it goes. Played out to the right, and helps available out wide. Time to deliver. What an adventurous run from a defender. That's a good block, but at the expense of a corner. Well, it seems as though someone has been forced to pull up lame here.
Yeah, maybe a touch of cramp, Peter. Hopefully nothing more serious than that.
Looks as though he's going to see if he can shake it off.
Massive leap! Decent attempt, but not quite good enough. Been intercepted, and that will come to nothing. Tries a shot! Oh, that's a waste. Tested the keeper.
Well, they're being made to force the issue, but they need to be patient and a little more composed.
Tries to get it forward quickly. And it's played forward. Almost nothing left on the clock here. Just a few moments from glory. And the weighted pass. Just 5 minutes left. He's made sure that that won't get through.
Goalkeeper's ball.
Calabria drives it forward and back to base.
Away from immediate danger.
Board shows there will be 3 extra minutes.
Dangerous looking ball, and it's come to nothing.
So now we're going to get those changes we have been expecting.
Well, he's worked so hard for his side, as you would expect, but you couldn't help notice that he was starting to labour a bit, so it's no surprise.
Managed to get it away. And there goes the final whistle. Sunderland have done it. It is party time as they gather to get their hands on the trophy. What a moment this is for all connected with the team. It's a day for pride, a day for glory. Another grand chapter to be added to their glittering history.